Dakar 2020. New horizons and a new host country, Saudi Arabia. The battle will be fought over 7,000 kilometres between the four-wheel drive Toyota Hilux and the two-wheel drive buggies. A rookie rolled. There were plenty of punctures and spectacular scenery. Fernando Alonso had the world's eyes watching his progress, which was halted on stage two by hitting a hole. After that, he drove for pleasure and made headlines.
Happy to be here. Obviously, this is the toughest rally in the world, and we finished in the first attempt. I had the best team around me, you know, all the Toyota GAZOO guys and Mark in the car, and I think thanks to them, you know, we finished in the first attempt.
Fernando finished 13th. Bernard Ted Brinker, an equal career best 7th. He struggled with illness in the first week and a lot of punctures, but in total felt his pace was closer to his experienced teammates. Janil Villiers spent his year developing the Hilux, so there is no one who knows the car better. A stage win on day two was a highlight he was unable to match for the rest of the route. Punctures and a pain in his neck didn't help. The second week, he did climb from 7th to finish 5th overall. Nasser Al-Attiyah was favourite coming into the rally, but punctures suffered by the four-wheel drive cars meant he was always chasing the buggies. He suffered a 3-minute penalty, a 17-minute time loss when hunting a waypoint, yet he was only 6 minutes off the win.
To finish also second in our hall is not easy, you know, with Carlos and Stefan, you know. I am sure next year will come and we'll fight and we'll win this race again.